Hello, I'm Aaron Marino from Alpha M, and over the course of the past few years, you have developed quite an impressive wardrobe. Or maybe you've just started the wardrobe upgrade process, and you are currently adding and building that new sassy wardrobe one stylish piece at a time. Now, regardless of how much money you have or how much money you've spent on your clothes, you want them to look as good as they can for as long as they can. It comes down to how you take care of your clothes. And so today, Clothing Care 101. And I'm not going into detail on how to do a load of laundry. This is more of a general video, a beginner's guide to keeping your gear looking great. Alright, the first and easiest thing to do is learn to read. What? I'm not messing with you. Listen, each and every piece of clothing that you buy has care instructions on a tag, stitched directly into the item. Machine wash cold with light colors, tumble dry low, do not use bleach. And then all it is a function of making it happen, and for that there are generally three options. Option number one, get your mom, wife, boyfriend, or girlfriend to do it. Sweet! I guess there's no need for step two and three. That's it, I'll see you next week, gentlemen. Yo! Seriously, that is total cop-out. You can't let somebody else do your own laundry. Or I should say, you need to at least learn how to do your own laundry. Alright? We as men need to be self-sufficient. We are men! We can do things on our own, and laundry happens to be one of those skills we need to learn. Alright, three options. Option number one, do it yourself. Option number two, have the professionals do it. And option number three, and one that I actually recommend, is a mix and a cross between option one and option two. There are some things that you can do, but there are some things that should probably be left to the professionals. Alright, now let's get down to business. We're going to start with the Alpha M rule of dry cleaning. If the clothing you are wearing ever ate, walked, or pooped, or it was the hair of something that ate, walked, or pooped, it needs to go to the dry cleaner. This includes items made of, but not limited to, leather, snakeskin, chinchilla, cashmere, moose, and wool. Dry cleaning is the process of cleaning an item or article of clothing using chemicals instead of water. Yeah, that's all it really is. And it is generally used for items that are made of fabrics that are a little bit more delicate and can't handle the rough and tumble washing machine or dryer. And dry cleaning is really the only option for suits, sport coats, nice wool pants, merino wool sweaters, cashmere sweaters, leather jackets, leather chaps. If you got them, wear them, I say. But the downside is that dry cleaning gets expensive, but the good news is that items that you dry clean, generally you don't need to take after each and every wear. How many wears you can get out of an item before taking it to the cleaner is really up to you and what you're actually doing in that item when you're wearing it. So if you spill something on it, chances are you gotta take it. If you're doing something or you get incredibly stinky or in an environment where you get smelly, cigarette smoke, stuff like that, you may wanna take it and need to take it more frequently. One tip I would give you when dealing with your suit, if you spill something on the jacket, you need to take both the jacket and the pants to get cleaned together. You don't wanna clean one more than the other, or they're not going to match. So if you're taking that jacket more often than the pants, the jacket is going to fade, it's going to get worn looking differently than the pants, and the suit isn't going to match. So if you're taking one item, you need to take the other matching item so that it always matches. Alright, so now let's talk about washing your clothes yourself, and we're going to go over some basic simple guidelines and keep it as simple as possible. Always wash your clothes in cold water. I know there are other settings, but you won't screw anything up if you stick to cold water washing. But before you get all crazy washing in cold water, you gotta make sure that you separate your clothing by color. We're gonna keep it simple. Three piles, three separate loads. You've got whites, you've got blacks and grays, and then you've got everything else, aka colors. Alright, time to be honest by show of hands. Who out there just takes their dirty clothes and dumps them in the wash? No separation. I know, man. I've been there, but I saw the light. The light, truth be told, happened to come when I washed a red shirt with some white underwear, or should I say pink underwear. Gentlemen, you gotta separate your colors, all right? This is the key to keeping your clothes looking crisp and fresh. If you don't separate, your clothing is going to, over time, become dingy and dull. Now you're gonna need a detergent, and really it comes down to personal preference. You've got liquids, you've got powders, it's up to you. But now let's talk about dryer sheets and fabric softeners. Now, the upside, they make your clothes smell great and it reduces static cling. The downside, it's actually bad for your clothing fibers. What happens with fabric softeners and dryer sheets, they actually coat the clothing with waxes and perfumes. Those dryer sheets, you know when you put it in, it feels a little bit, that's wax that's melting. When you pull them out, you're like, ooh, it's just like a little paper towel. Right, no static cling, great. Your clothes smell good, but it's not great for your clothes. Now let's talk about bleach. And the only thing I'm gonna say about bleach is that bleach scares me, dude. Straight up, honestly, I don't know how to use it. Right, I mean, I could probably learn. I'm a smart enough guy, but it scares me. I don't want to risk getting it on something that it shouldn't be on and thus ruining the item. So bleach, if you want to learn how to use bleach, you're on your own, Jack. All right, so separate, wash. Now it's time to dry. Now, the first thing I'm going to say is if you don't want something to shrink, like if it fits you perfectly, do not, I repeat, do not put it in the dryer. Lay it out, invest in a drying rack, let that item air dry. When it's dry, it's gonna be a little crispy, a little crunchy. Then you can toss it in the dryer, put it on a low setting, and tumble dry it a little bit, and that's gonna make it a little bit softer. But if you don't want something to shrink, don't stick it in the dryer. Who out there has bought something and asked the sales rep, yo, is this pre-shrunk? It fits me. And they're like, yeah, it's pre-shrunk. You're good to go. And then 2 weeks later, you keep drying that shirt and you look like Britney Spears in a crop top. Well, the deal is you really got to be careful. Most garments, if they're cotton, are going to shrink. Now, jeans, let's talk about jeans specifically. All right, jeans will shrink. Over the course of a year, if you're drying them regularly in a dryer, are gonna shrink up a half to a full inch. Jeans generally shrink vertically. They do not shrink horizontally. This is due to the way that the fibers are woven together. Some items that I never put in the dryer are going to be my nice lightweight shorts. I let them hang dry. Also my cotton cardigans or any cotton sweater that I have. Another thing is button-up dress shirts. I'll wash them, but then I hang dry them and then iron them. We'll talk about that in a second. Another thing that I never put in the dryer are my jeans, all right? So I hang dry them. One little trick that you can use if you want to keep the color of your jean and you don't want your jeans to fade is actually turn them inside out prior to washing them. And what's going to happen is you are going to greatly reduce the amount of fading that happens. All right, an item that requires a little bit more discussion are dress shirts, all right? So the deal is I used to just launder them, hang dry them, and then iron them. But that is a pain in the ass, and it takes a while. And you really need to determine what the value of your time and frustration level is. All right, so me, I have switched to another option, and that is taking my shirts to get laundered and pressed at the cleaners. What I do, and something you may want to consider, is keep a separate laundry basket in your closet that is exclusively for dress shirts. So you wear your dress shirts, you toss them in this basket. When the basket gets full, you take it to the cleaner and have them launder and press the shirts. Generally, the pressing and laundering of those shirts are only going to cost you around $2. It is much cheaper than having a shirt dry cleaned. Now the question is, to starch or not to starch? Personally, I say no to starch, and there are three specific reasons why. Reason number one is comfort. Starch makes clothing feel stiff. It also can get a little bit itchy and prevents clothing from breathing. It also prevents the evaporation of perspiration. Second reason is wrinkles. Now, when you first rip open that bag and you see that freshly starched shirt, it is like glass. It's smooth because the starch gives it a nice smooth finish to the pressing process. But here's the deal. You put it on, you're good for a few minutes, you start to move around, your shirt is going to get wrinkles. And a starched shirt's wrinkles are actually more noticeable. And the third reason is lifespan. Starch builds up over repeated cleanings, and this buildup of starch actually causes your clothing's fiber to become weak, brittle, and stiff. In conclusion, gentlemen, clothing care, it is essential. You take care of your clothes. Your clothes, they will take care of you. They will look good longer. You don't take care of them, they're not gonna last as long. All right, gentlemen, I want you to look as sharp, as polished, as put together as you possibly can. And taking care of and taking pride in the clothing that you have doesn't just happen when you wear it. It happens when you clean it as well. Thanks for watching. I'll talk to you later. So Pete and Pedro update. All right, so I knew you guys would like it because the products are amazing. I didn't know how much you would love it though. Seriously, I've been getting the most ridiculous testimonials. Things like this. First off, I'd like to say thank you so much for recommending the clay. I absolutely love it. It smells amazing but doesn't overpower. And most importantly, it does the job perfectly. I'm definitely hooked on Pete and Pedro for life. Best product I've ever had. The fast shipping was awesome too. Thanks, man. Kevin A. But I know there are those of you out there that are hesitant because you don't want to waste money. There's nothing worse than wasting money on hair product that isn't right for your hair. Well, good news. We at Pete and Pedro aim to help everybody and anybody who would like a recommendation. If you send an email to hairhelp@peteandpedro.com, there's information down below, we will help you with your specific hair needs. All right, you want to send a picture of your current hair? Cool. The product that you're currently using? Cool. What you like, what you don't like about that product? We will help and make a personalized recommendation so you too can obtain bueno hair.